स्कॉलरशिप आईडी म्यूट योर फोन। ओके सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी आर एट द फोर्थ लेक्चर टू अवर सीरीज रिसर्च एंड पब्लिकेशन एथिक्स आरपीई रिसर्च फिलोसफी एथिक्स एंड साइंटिफिक कंडक्ट। Thanks for the kind cooperation and also thanks for the chance given by our Dean Madam towards me. Philosophy and Ethics and Scientific Conduct is the unit. Here we completed Introduction to Philosophy, Intellectual Honesty and Research Integrity in 3 hours. Now we have to look for redundant publications, duplicate and overlapping publications, salami slicing, selective reporting, and misrepresentation of data. So in this present unit, I will recollect what we have done in the first 3 classes at the end. Now we will go ahead with the last 2 lines. One is redundant publication. Second one is duplicate and overlapping publication. Third one is salami slicing, in which selective reporting and misrepresentation of data. And references therein. Repeat, this class contents are: what are redundant publications? Discussion. 2. Duplicate and overlapping publication. 3. Salami slicing, selective reporting, and misrepresentation of data. 5. References. First, let us start with the redundant publications. A redundant publication, duplicate publication, multiple publication. Redundant publication refers to publishing the same intellectual material more than once by the author or by the publisher. Edition is different. You must have a differentiation between first edition, second edition of a book, third edition of a book, and fourth edition of a book. That is different. That contains same data only. For example, if you take Fortran programming by X, first edition would have been in 1972, second edition would have been in 1988, third maybe in 2002. Likewise, each and every subject, the edition is different. That is not called as a redundant publication. So duplicate publication, multiple publication, or redundant publication refers to publishing the same intellectual material more than once by the author or publisher. For books, that is different. It doesn't refer to the unauthorized republication by someone else. If you take a Xerox and distribute to somebody else, that is not one, which constitutes plagiarism, copyright violation, or even both. That is what is called as a redundant publication. By another author, without getting the permission of the first person, without acknowledging the source and without getting the permission of the original author, it is called a duplicate publication. We are just like that going to across the across the counter, one can go with a book and photocopy few pages. That is also wrong. Unless otherwise we get the permission. Since it is a study material, nobody is objecting. If it is going for sales and also marketing, then it will be objected. Duplicate publication, when you publish a new paper similar to your published paper by another author or yours in science, without acknowledging the source and without getting the permission of the original author, even for a graph, if you want to reproduce from one book in your paper, then it is called as a duplicate publication. Even if you change the title or the abstract, the data and the results remain the same. That you please notice again. A duplicate publication, when you publish a new paper similar to a published paper by another author or yours, without acknowledging the source, and without getting the permission of the original author, it is called the duplicate publication. Even if you change the title or the abstract, or even add or delete certain authors, the data and the results, if they are remaining the same, then it is duplicate publication. So I removed one author, I added another author, few lines from the original data has been added. A few more algorithms are also incorporated, and review paper has been compared with my original paper. So it is a different paper if somebody says it is wrong. So we have several papers. I compared a table in this paper, so it is a new paper. It's not so. Why is duplicate publication a problem? It violates, number one, copyright for the paper. You are just giving a signature for copyright. Researchers who study the subject may count the same set of results twice. That is the problem. They will quote in the reference or bibliography the same one twice. That is the problem with most of the comparisons. That is the problem. In one paper using an A algorithm, they would have got LSB value of 50. In another paper using their algorithm, it may be 18. Likewise, they have a comparative statement. Not only in this computer science or something else, but most of that, it is the case. It is a menace. Researchers who study the subject may count the same set of results twice and thus distort the empirical evidence. Okay. Since empirical studies form the base of many health policies, it becomes a serious problem, especially in the current scenario. how many COVID patients are actually now admitted, if you are giving a different data that has been published elsewhere, that is not right. Republication of your own work without attribution surmounts to self-plagiarism. Suppose I published a paper some 3 years back, on same paper, one paragraph has been taken, and once again that is compared with my results in my another paper, now it is republished, then it will become a self-plagiarism. I'm copying my own paper. Of course, my first paper is also genuine. Second paper is also genuine. I can add my first paper as a reference, not as a paragraph in the second paper. That is so-called a self-plagiarism. It leads to the wastage of editorial and review resources. Republication of the same work unjustly takes up the limited journal space. Republication of the same work unjustly takes up the limited journal space. That is another one. You are unnecessarily cutting short of one more paper space in that volume. Some other paper, new paper would have been published since you are republishing it. Republication of the same work unjustly takes up limited journal space and denies another author's right to publish their work in the same volume on same month and year. So these are all certain discrepancies that student has to work on it. We should totally depend on, if you are publishing a first paper, second paper, the first paper content should not be in the second paper, and you can give it as a reference. That's fine. So it violates the copyright of the paper. Researchers who study the subject may count the same set of results twice, thus distort the empirical evidence. Since empirical studies form the base of many health policies, it becomes a serious problem in health sector. Republication of your own work without attribution surmounts to self-plagiarism, I explained clearly. It leads to the wastage of editorial and review resources. Time. Republication of the same work unjustly takes up limited journal space and denies another author's right to publish their work. Okay. Why is duplicate publication a problem? What do journals say about this issue? The editorial committee of the academic journals instruct the authors, do not submit the papers or variations of papers already published elsewhere. You look at it. Are we following? You are all youngsters. You are joining in 2020 and you should follow this. The editorial committees of the academic journals, get into it. For science journals, you have to refer first. In my opinion, you can go into the current contents that will give the current data alone. But if you want to get a perfect editorial journal instruction in India, Indian Academy of Sciences published from IISc Bangalore for all scientific community, including engineering, and particularly for all sciences, you please go into the instruction, you will find it. If you publish a paper in Indian Academy of Sciences, it has given different names for different subjects. You go into it, it will be interesting. But publication as if you are having the standard, then only it will be published. If you go for chemistry, the journal name is called as Resonance. If you go for medicine, it is called as Swasthada. All Sanskrit names has been placed, but its impact factor is very high. Very difficult to publish a paper in that. Once you publish a paper in that, it is equal to American Society. So get the instructions. Editorial committees of the academic journals instruct the authors, do not submit the papers or variations or papers already published elsewhere. They design stringent policies and ask the authors to send copies of older related articles along with the submitted paper. That is not usually done in most of the journals, even in international level. But the journal which seems to be standard, they are asking all these things, or they are giving instruction to the referees to do so and also get into it. Peep into that, and based on that, referee could give their results. What do the journals say about the issue? I told now. Editorial committees of the academic journals instruct the authors, do not submit the papers or variations, even a small variation, or papers already published elsewhere. They design stringent policies and ask the authors to send copies of older related articles along with the submitted paper. It is safe for us. However, republication is allowed in some cases. Where? When? A follow-up on a published preliminary report. So if you look into certain journals, earlier published, very good journals. Replica, Mirrors, etc. You can follow that. I can give part one. Some title I can give my paper, part one. The second paper I can give as a part two. Third paper I can give as a part three, like that. However, republication is allowed in some cases. A follow-up on a published preliminary report. Why we have to give a preliminary report for a journal? Because somebody would have been doing the same thing elsewhere in the world. Similarly, you would have got about who invented radio, Marconi, everybody says. But before Marconi, J.C. Bose has invented our radio. Nobody knows that. But J.C. Bose not communicated in the right time because the distance between the British journal and India is high. Still, people used to say that. However, republication is allowed in the cases. A follow-up on published a preliminary report, an abstract, poster, or conference presentation is a preliminary report. Then you can elaborate that and submit as a separate paper. A paper with a list of the guidelines prepared by professional societies or governmental agencies. Then you can go for a republication. A paper that reanalyzes or reinterprets the findings of the study for a different audience. You take the paper, interpret the findings of the study for a different audience, a translation of the original paper, e-prints of the paper in repositories. A paper that reanalyzes or reinterprets the findings of the study for a different audience. Then you can go for republication. A translation of the original paper, e-prints of the paper in repositories. You know about repositories, go to our general library, ask the librarian what is a repository. He will say and explain and show it to you. No problem. Despite these exceptions, authors must adhere to the following guidelines. Get permission from the copyright holders. Get approval from the editor of the journals in which the paper was first published, and the editor of the journal in which they will republish it. Acknowledge the source of a republication by providing the full citation. Acknowledge the source of your republication by providing its full citation. So these are all certain methodologies. Despite these exceptions, authors must adhere to the following guidelines. Get permission from the copyright holders. get approval from the editor of the journal in which the paper was first published and the editor of the journal in which they will republish it. Acknowledge the source of a republication by providing its full citation. Next one. For the past 25 minutes, we have seen about republication. So we started with this redundant publication, duplicate and overlapping publication. Now redundant publication we have seen. Duplicate publications. Multiple publications or redundant publications refers to a publishing the same intellectual material more than once. I told you. Duplicate publication published by another author of yours without acknowledging the source. Why does a duplicate publication is a problem? Copyright is violated. What do journals say about the issue? I told that. When and where the republication is allowed, that is also given. There are certain exceptions. Following guidelines should be caught. If you are getting a copyright holder permission, then it's okay. If you acknowledge the source of a republication by providing the full citation, it is also well and good. Now we have to go for overlapping publications. What's an overlapping publication? Duplicate submission. Some people very cleverly follow the technique. So they will prepare one manuscript sent to several journals at the same time. So which journal editor or the referee gives the first report, they will take into account. And the rest of the journal, they will just reject it. So duplicate submissions. Duplicate publication. You can publish the same content in different journals. Redundant publication. Acceptable secondary publication. If it is acceptable, then it is called as a secondary publication. Competing manuscripts. Manuscripts may be the same and competing because using one part in one journal and another part in another journal but belonging to the same area. Those are all called competing manuscripts of the same study, same database, and sibling publication. Sibling means their own daughters or sons. One publication, from that one particular area is changed, different area is introduced. But the concept, content, results, discussion, everything will be same. If you use the same content instead of X, if you use Y, then that is called as sibling of publications. That is not advisable. These are all called overlapping publications. Duplicate publication, accept with the same study, same database, and sibling publication, I explained clearly. What is a sibling publication? Instead of X, use the same thing for Y, Z, etc. Duplicate submissions. Most journals will not consider simultaneously submitted manuscripts. So, as a research scholar, you should know for the same journal, don't submit two papers simultaneously. You first submit a paper first and wait for at least one referee report or two referee report, then go for the second one. In a haphazard fashion and a faster move, don't improve your velocity. Be kinetic, but don't improve your velocity in these things. So most journals will not consider simultaneously submitted manuscripts. Potential for disagreement over right to publish among journals. That is very important. potential for disagreement. Even in the editor's table, it will be rejected. Possibility of unnecessary duplication of peer review on editing is acceptable. Possibility of unnecessary duplication of peer review on editing is acceptable. When both editors believe it is in the best interest of public health, paper has been rejected by another journal, full report following submission of abstract. Okay. These are all for duplicate publications. Redundant publication. Publication of a paper that substantially overlaps with an already published article, unethical first. Waste of time of peer reviewers and editors. Waste of resources and journal pages leads to flawed meta-analysis, distorts academic reward system, infringes on copyright. Infringe means violation, breaking, not obeying. These are all the vocabularies. Infringement of copyright, inflates scientific literature for no benefit other than to author. Author only getting benefited if you are going for redundant publication. Scientific community as a whole do not. Okay. What are the editorial responsibilities? Actually, I am being an editor now for a prestigious journal, Cancer Research and Chemical Biology. I am a guest editor. I have been given an assignment for collecting special issues papers also. I am not referring all these on my own. I am sending to prestigious referees. Their reports is taken in and that is submitted to journal main editor. And he will consider whether that is publishable or not. Even on his table, if the referee's reports are also positive, he is having the right to reject at any point of time over a single matter. Prompt rejection of submitted manuscript. If article has already been published, publication of notice of duplicate publication can also be done. Even one part or a graph, if it assumes to be somewhat spurious or even it is having a cloud over it, then they can go ahead with that without asking any clarification of the author and they may reject it. Possible copyright violation. Inform other editor or publisher. Inform employer institution of author. And one can go ahead with sanctions against author by blacklisting. His paper will not be taken into account for any even manuscript refereeing. That is called as sanctions against the author. So editorial responsibilities of this, whether the editorial responsibilities are being followed or not, that depends on the journal, its quality. How widespread is the problem? I just collected among articles in 70 ophthalmological journals between 1997 and 2000. Majun Azzi et al., 2003, Nature, 421, 209, 1.39% were considered redundant. Okay. 32 out of 70 journals victim of duplicate publication. 210 authors were involved. No significant difference between impact factor of primary and secondary journals. However, elsewhere reported only 10 cases last in year among all their journals. But if you go into that in deep, you can find that nearly 36 to 46% of the papers are redundant. One way or other way, it is duplicate. That's the truth. But in a general sense of social problem or so general scientific content, it is okay. If you are giving a data, particularly for in the line of medicine, then it is not advisable and allowable. In systematic reviews, W. Van L., this is for you while you are writing the examination answer, question answer. You must quote all these things. That's why I am giving this. It is not harmful to anybody, but this is data. It is already there in the internet, and I just gone into it and collected. Journal of American Medical Association. Why I have taken Medical Association? One thing is I am very acquainted to that. Second thing is, this is very important than social sciences or even chemical or physical sciences, biological sciences. Medical science totally come to public, society. Here, 141 systematic review screened for duplicate publication. 30% reported duplication. Authors of the other 99 systematic review contacted. They are contacted because I told you it totally depends on the quality of the journal. 14 reported duplicate publication not mentioned in the original review. 55 did not identify any duplicate publication at all. They are not accepted to. 30 did not respond. If they are not responding it, automatically it will be blacklisted. That is the point. So, my dear young students, while you are going for publication of a result after 1 year or even 6 months, don't be hurry. Don't be rapid. Kindly go into the system and collect all the information, whether that is published or not. If you are going for a purchase of a home or a plot, immediately you will go for encumbrance certificate like that. For publication of your data in a journal as a paper, you should go for an encumbrance certificate, nothing but seeing carefully the pre-references. So, in Van L. et al. JAMA, 141 systematic review screened for duplicate publication. 30% reported as duplication. Authors of other 99 systematic reviews contacted. 14 reported duplicate publications not mentioned in the original review. 55 did not identify any duplicate publication at all. 30 did not respond. Overall, 56 systematic reviews, 40% with duplicate publication were seen. Times published. You see the graph. 56 systematic reviews. 1131 main articles with 1,29,000 patients. 103 articles were duplicates. 8% of the total with 12,500 patients. 9% of the total. Many of the 103 articles were duplicated several times. In a medical field, one should not do that, knowingly or unknowingly. So till then, what you have seen is redundant publication, its nature, redundant publication, editorial responsibilities, how widespread is the problem. I have given certain references with respect to the medicine journals and also in systematic reviews with classic examples. Now we have to say, what is salami slicing? It is simply a term, that's all, but it is understandable. Let me say one thing. While I did my research even for 7 years, I published only 2 papers because whole thesis I never cut short into pieces and published. Instead, one particular study has published as a whole for 46 pages in a very standard journal. The second paper, another 36 pages, without slicing it or cutting short into that, and that they published. Okay. So what they want to say is, you would have done a work, a composite work, you should not publish in 5 or 6 different journals same work by slicing it. Algorithm alone one, or if a compound is prepared, preparation alone one. In a physics, if you have just prepared a nanomaterial, preparation of nanomaterial alone in one journal, then characterization of the nanomaterial in another journal, and analytical data concerned with the same in another journal, then application of particular nanomaterial in future in another journal should not be. That should not be. That is called as salami slicing. So if your aim, motivation, content, and also objective are going over a single point, then collect all the things and publish as a whole single paper, particularly for computer science and engineering. If you go for IEEE, that will be better. Don't slice it. What slicing will give you? The benefit is number of papers published by the author will be more. That's all. I published 5 papers, 8 papers. What is the content and what's the mode? What's the objective? Objective will not be satisfied with this one. That is called as slicing. Salami is a meat product like a sausage. We love to slice it thinly to many pieces. For taking a food, it is okay. Like a bread in slices. One, you can use it with the egg. One, you can use it with jam. One, you can use it with butter. Okay. That is slicing. They all still salami in publication. One can create many papers from one single idea or even an experiment done using theoretically MATLAB or even going to the field and conducting certain experiments using artificial intelligence, etc. The practice of fragmenting single research into as many publications as possible is the actual meaning of what is called as a salami slicing. So one should avoid it. In each and every branch of science, you can apply the same. And the final point is, if your motivation and objective is towards a single point, single idea, you collect all that supports that idea. Suppose if I get some injury, immediately my doctor will go for all blood analysis. After getting the all blood analysis data, he will come to a conclusion. This may be a diagnosed disease possibility. And then further drug which has to be prescribed by him will be prescribed by us. Instead, if you totally depend on only the clinical data, then analysis, then other things, it is not possible for us to come to any good conclusion for a prescription of a medicine. That prescription of the medicine is nothing but conclusion that you are giving over a paper after carrying out carefully for more than 1.5 years, your research idea implemented finally.
Okay.
So the concept is the practice of fragmenting single research into many publications. Please avoid it. Even if you publish a single paper in a standard journal, that will do. Number do not count. The content and the quality alone counts. That is accountable. Accountability should be there, not the countability. Scientific salami slicing is a practice of fragmenting single coherent bodies of research into as many publications as possible. An author breaks up a study into 2 or more similar published articles. They are creating slices of their own work, but focus is same, objective is same. They got the motivation is also same. Whether the motivation came from the gate or his own, but it is not fully satisfied, but purified. A single research is divided into slices, each of which is a least publishable unit. Everybody knows. If we just break into pieces, It's the least publishable unit. 2 pages, 3 pages. Page is different. Content. Authors do it to increase their publication count to get more recognition. One of my former deans who had been here in the physics department, the head and dean, in a particular meeting around 25 years back, he told that I'm a growing research scholar at the time and also a young lecturer, got 2 projects at the time. He told that when I gone to him and shown a paper of my own, he told that Sir C.V. Raman got Nobel Prize, not published, not more than 2 papers. He has given me actually the Nobel Prize report given by him for the invention of Raman lines. Only 6 sentences. He told that for 6 sentences, not in his paper, but in his, he's given us a message, Journal of Radio Engineering, published from Italy. It's a message given. For that, he got Nobel Prize. I, as a research scholar, joined nearly completed 39 years. I published only in good journals, I can say, 109 papers. So, but all are in somewhat different field, counting around 31 PhD scholars. One PhD scholar, 2 papers and 3 papers, that's all. The whole work. A single research is divided into slices, each of which is a least publishable unit. Authors do it to increase their publication count, to get more recognition, to achieve self-satisfaction. I published 1,000 papers. I published 800 papers. I published 700 papers. To achieve faster career progression, become associate, to become a professor, then to become elsewhere, to get rewards and awards, to receive more funding. The desire to publish new results, why salami slicing, is done by the people. We have to avoid young students. You must see all these things not to just implicate who did and where it is done like that. What we should not do like that. To desire to publish new results rapidly, that's fine. If somebody is competing with you in some other lab, even in India or elsewhere, you have to go for first publication. For that alone, what we do is, if you are synthesizing a new compound in chemistry, immediately we will go for, our department possesses single crystal XRD, where most of the labs do not know having it in working condition. Even IIT, we had to wait for 6 months, but in chemistry department, we can record the single crystal XRD of any compound or any material through which you can publish a lot of papers even in computer science and mathematics. People do not know that. So if you have a single crystal data of any material, it is just like for a human being. The difference between CAT, is CAT scan. That is called as computer-aided tomography. And another one is called as, you have MRI. MRI is nothing but magnetic resonance imaging. What's the best between these two, which is the best if you look into it? MRI, because it do not have any radiation at all. On the other day, some 10 days back, I had been to Delhi. After just coming out of the airport, I have been taken by people to the nearby best hospital. My MRI has been taken off a chest without my concern. You understand that? They took the MRI, they took the CAT scan, and finally found some 3% of addition is there, and it may be due to, you would have been a smoker else some time back, like that they told. No COVID. Right. Likewise, the difference between MRI and CAT scan is CAT is injurious because if you are just inside for 5 minutes, nearly your brain or the whole body is dissected, multisected by X-rays more than 6,000 times. But magnetic resonance imaging, it is not so. The desire to publish new results rapidly, the desire to researchers to maximize their publication count, but limited conditions of funding on university publish or perish, climatic overemphasizes. On the size of an individual publication record as a means of quantifying the research output, rewards quantify over quality. That is the point. So you all do good research and publish less papers, but more a quality paper. This will slowly vanish. The number of papers publication is the exposition of a researcher. The volume of a researcher's publication output is criterion on which their scientific accomplishment is judged. Now also it is like that. If you go for I-10, how many times, 10 times your paper is just referred. H-index, etc. That is not wrong. The metrics is not wrong. But as a researcher, all of you should burn in mind that we have to go for a good journal for our publication, even if it is taking time. If you go for the impact factor of any mathematical journal, you will be surprised to know not more than 1.5 or 2 may be the maximum. But if you go for a biological journal, let's say Cell, its impact factor is 36. So how a mathematician can reach a paper which is published in a journal called Cell, 36 impact factor, one paper. Whereas for mathematics, good journal, maybe 1.2 or 1.3. So it is subject oriented. For that, we cannot degrade that mathematics research is not good, etc. But it is superior. It's not the case. It is not the metric that actually compares. The quality of the work. The desire to publish new results rapidly. That is salami slicing's outcome. The desire of researchers to maximize the publication count, but limited conditions of funding. Our university publish or perish climate that is occurring till date in all the foreign universities. Now also it is the case. If you are not publishing, you will not recognized. Go perish. Overemphasize on the size of the individual publication to get awards and rewards. And record as a means of quantifying the research output. Rewards quantify over quality. The volume of researchers' publication output is a criterion till now on which their scientific accomplishment is judged. It is not how many papers we have to publish. What is the content we have to publish? Even if the award is given, we have to receive a lecture from them for our general students. That will be good. Is not being done. This is a meat, salami meat, and it's called a Tannosa salami. An intelligent and automatic face shape prediction system from fingerprints, a fantastic paper. It's from computer science. This is for the favor of the computer science, my dear research scholars. This paper, if you go into it, its origin, and also I told you about the benchmark paper. If you go into the benchmark paper, you will find a fantastic idea and results as you are an originator or a new researcher in computer science. Even if you go into that and get the idea, you can have a good publication, at least one or two out of this idea. He left a lot of gap in his paper. I read that yesterday. An intelligent and automatic face shape prediction system from fingerprints. So using a fingerprint, how a person's face can be predicted. It's a very fine paper. So he compared more than 15 lakhs people, fingerprints, on the face photographic expressions without distortion. and found this fingerprint is there on the face of the people and the color of the people will be this, like that. Very good paper. Selective reporting and misrepresentation of data. Next one. I hope I am not boring you. And we are coming to nearly 60 minutes. I will take another 10 minutes and I will just recall what you have done in the past three lectures and certain questions and also some objective types for your references. And then you have to submit assignment out of it. Any doubt and clarification I will get from your booklet. And I will try to clarify any other assistance is needed for further notes or study material. I am ready to give. I am always with you. I am not invisible. Now I am invisible. That is different. But I will be here and you can get idea from our dean. And I will be always helpful. So misuse of research. Intentional misinterpretation of data. I came across several times. For example, in statistics, while you are analyzing all scientific data, you have one is called as student t-test significance and f-test significance. So most of us are most of the researchers do not understanding, and they will go directly from chemistry department to statistics department. They are having statistical analysis tool. They will give ANOVA program, out of which they will go for multiple regression analysis. First, without understanding what's a multiple regression analysis, should be done for most of the research work, particularly concerning consistency with biochemistry, chemistry, physics, even in zoology. I just submitted my thesis in 1988. Even at the time, I did a lot of ANOVA work and also multiple regression analysis to my research work. So in that, one is called as F-test significance. That is reliability. Okay, FISA, reliability data. If I say my F-test significance is 99.9%, then my data is unreliable by not 1%. So we should know also the difference between the percentage and percentile score. What's the percentile? In GATE examination, they will give percentile score. In NEET examination, they are giving percentage score. There is a difference. For CSIR examination, the whole mathematics, all the research scholars, mostly 1,500 people only writing. If one person out of 100 marks, if he is getting 50 mark as the first mark, he is called as a 100 percentile. That's the point. The second rank is 49.5. is 99 percentile, 99.9 percentile. So having taken into account of the percentile score, it is not possible to say that student has answered all the 100 questions correctly. Among the best, among the competitors, he is the best. He is called 100 percentile. So intentional misinterpretation, data loss, data theft, allowing access to unauthorized users, not allowing access to those who should have access to data, research group members, pseudo-anonymization. These are all the misuse of research data. Pseudo-guidance also, selective reporting and misrepresentation of data. You may get another 10 or 20 more question. That is nothing but misuse of research data. Intentional misinterpretation, you can understand. Data loss, you lost the data. Data theft, allowing access to unauthorized users, not allowing access to those who should have access to data. That is very important. Pseudo-anonymization. Authorship-related misconduct. Bogus claims of authorship. He would not have been involved in the research, but for the favor of getting the paper number count, he would have told his friend to add his name. In most of the cases, it is being done. Bogus claims of authorship, not crediting an author. A person would have been helped in brain and also in work. His name would not have been added wantonly. Gift honorary authorship, crediting as an author a person who was not involved as an author. Ghost authorship. Ghost, invisible authorship. A person is not at all there. Conflict of interest. Somebody would have been done the data, somebody would have been in the author. Conflict of interest, nature journals. Each manuscript must include a statement of responsibility that specify the contribution of every author lost. So you must understand the term conflict of interest. What's a conflict of interest? Even for newspapers, journals, conflict of interest should be given. Each new manuscript must include a statement of responsibility. I am responsible. Anything good in this paper, anything bad in this paper, anything wrong data is given, I am responsible. It is called as conflict of interest that specify the contribution of every author. I did synthesis, I did infrared, I did NMR, I did mass, I did microbiological analysis, I did mathematical statistical calculation. Maybe 7 authors. That is, each one is responsible for their own part. That is called as conflict of interest. So these are all called as authorship related misconduct. While you are answering the questions, you must be aware of all these things in the last unit. Now let me recall of early lecture and I will complete in short because I don't want to give time to you now. Later we can have. So on 8th, we took in the present unit for the paper, Philosophy, Ethics and Scientific Conduct, 2 hours lecture, Introduction of Philosophy. We did definition and questions also given. Nature and scope is also given. And concept of the philosophy in research is also given. What are the branches of philosophy concerned with the research, scientific research is also given. Notes is also there. Lecture notes is there. Any extra is needed, I will prepare. On the second lecture, Ethics in Scientific Research, on 9th, we took definition, moral philosophy, nature and moral judgment, reactions in that, ethics with respect to science and research is also given. I hope you all have this lecture content. On third one yesterday, we talked about intellectual honesty and research integrity. In that, we just recollected the previous one also, philosophy, nature, moral, judgments, etc. In that, along with that, we have intellectual honesty is the meaning of it. Research integrity is that. And scientific misconduct should not be. Falsification, what is the meaning of falsification and definitions? Fabrication and plagiarism is also done. Today, you know what we have done till now. And the today class goes into this. I'll tell you again. So we started with redundant publications, duplicate and overlapping publications, salami slicing. Your whole content of a work of yours may be of 3 chapters should be published as a single paper, not as 3 paper. That is the content. You would have given 7 units, 7 chapters. 3 chapters would have been for one paper. Another 4 chapters would have been for another paper. So number of papers published by an individual is not the wisdom that actually accounts for them. For getting the awards and rewards and also recognition and also funding, it may be. For showing the quality in future, please friends, you admit that also go for a good journal publication. Duplicate overlapping publications, slicing, I told you now, selective reporting, misrepresentation of data, Now we are at the references therein. So these are the references. There are several references. I am giving only a handful of references to you for ethical, philosophical, and also misinterpretation of data,
redundant data.
So I just given you answers. What is FP search? Misconduct, falsification, fabrication.
Which is an example of falsification research. Presenting false transcripts or references in application of a program. Submitting work which is not your own.
Or lying about the person if you are illness, not at the external deadline. Rules and regulations for submission that totally depends on when you join. You all people joined in 2020. Go into the website.
Wait.
So, publication overlap, definition, the presentation of redundant idea. I have given some small answer you can extend. Now it is the time to acknowledge. After that, I will take you the question time. My special thanks to Vice Chancellor Annamalai University, Registrar of Annamalai University, very particularly for Dean Faculty of Science, Annamalai University, along with two of my bosom friends, and they are computer science professors, working along with our dean and also here for successful conduct of this. And this paper is only first taken, I hope, by science faculty in this manner. Professor and head department of chemistry, Annamalai University, who has given permission to talk here. Research scholars and my student friends.
Unmute yourself and please ask questions. We have time today. Make maximum use of the eminent resource persons and just ask some questions.
See, the first person.
Congratulations.
Okay, thank you very much. And the second one is about my mail ID and contact number. And it is with the Dean Office. Contact number not necessary, I hope so. You can, if you ask anything, you can ask in mail ID. Attendance link, idhaan kekranga. Attendance link is given. Okay.
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay, tell me.
Sir, this is Ishfaq Mohideen Lone from Department of Zoology.
Okay.
How long do we need to wait to hear from a journal after submitting a manuscript?
That depends on the... So you would have seen the history of the manuscript and also person who has published in that. You can contact the person who has already published through the mail ID. You can get information how long it takes before submitting your manuscript to the concerned journal. Normally, okay. Now I am one of the editors, a special guest editor for a very standard journal concerned with zoology also. You can contact me later. So we are giving only 30 days, maximum 30 days for two referees. You can wait for 30 to 40 days, that's all. That is enough. And they will give the report. You can insist upon giving, if it is getting delayed, you can insist upon giving the email to them that I have submitted the paper and also manuscript. I'm waiting for that. Like that, you can give. Okay.
Any more questions, please?
My doubts are okay. Two questions left to inquire. What is the minimum number of clinical trials, research projects, an investigator can propose in a single year? Depends on the quantum of work you are taking. That's all. Depends on the quantum of work. In chemistry, suppose you think I can, I used to tell my students to prepare at least 5 to 6 compounds. One compound, synthesize, on its purification, quantification, an analytical observation, etc., will take at least a month. So I will tell them, go ahead with preparing 7 to 8 compounds and characterize completely, including the single crystallic solid. If they are doing it, if they are understanding, it is well and good. After you are getting experienced in the first year, the same thing you can do it within 3 months or 4 months. That is the point. I don't know which area you belong, paleontological or remote sensing, I don't know. That depends on the area where you are involved. And you can refer the any person doing in the area elsewhere and also here who have completed as your seniors, how long it will take. Because I'm, to be very frankly speaking, I'm not a geologist. Which area you are talking also, I'm not knowing it. And these things should be known, and you can inquire your good guide, and he or she will give you a good reference to you. For the first question. For second, here that plagiarism up to 15% is allowed. Is it correct or not? If so, is there any logic behind this 15%? So why they are given up to 14%, not 15%, but in most of, I used to have access to some other university like Mangalore, Karnataka University. They are allowing only 7%. So that depends. In some cases, they are not incorporating the introductory part. They are not incorporating the tables and only the writing, particularly results and discussion. In some other university, the wrapper to wrapper you have to submit and they are just finding that. In those cases, in my opinion, if your thesis is right, it should be unique. From wrapper to wrapper, every wording should be entirely different from what is. If you have time, you kindly visit Chemistry Department Library, which is now under renovation. I appreciate in the whole university, only one thesis about it. The name of the author of the thesis is Dr. Vedanta Desigan. So it is also now available at General Library. And the thesis pages is only 80. If you read the thesis, that is the thesis you will appreciate. The name of the author, PhD scholar, is Vedanta Desigan. He just went across the country and to Italy and retired as the Dean of Sciences in Italy. His thesis, I am interested in that. Your question is a very fine question. I just always I will be probing the General Library for different PhD theses. I hope I may be the first person to know who got the first PhD degree in the world. I don't want to expose now. You go into the website and find. If anybody is saying a PhD, who is the first PhD candidate? You find it. That is my first interventing question in my mind while I joined my PhD. I found out it is a very, 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 very fine surprise to me to see that. I got the information only from Annamalai University Library. from repository. So you will understand what is a repository. And you have the blue chips also, that is film. You have thesis in the film form, got from Great Britain. At the time, the librarians are great. One Dr. Durairaj, very fantastic person. He is the person, as a librarian, I used to move to him. He will not allow anybody to talk, but I used to disturb always because he is nearby to my home at Mariapanagar. He'll never refuse. He discussed with me. I'm not blaming others, but I have an appreciation. I have a role model. Somebody will be a role model like that, I'm telling. My guide is my role model. Like that, he is the librarian because he found the chips that is now placed at library. So if you go and read the Vedantadis and thesis, even it is available in our chemistry department, but now they are renovated, they placed elsewhere. But one copy will be always in the main library, thesis. You can go and search and read only 80 pages of the thesis, how the language is written, how the chapters are being made, what is a thesis, how the references are given. He is a student of the famous Balaya. Likewise, plagiarism, 15%, 20%, 30%, why you are thinking about in the first year itself? Don't worry about all these things. You just concentrate and focus on your work. After, write on your own. Any doubt is there, consult an English professor. And he will say how to avoid redundancy in sentences. And everybody is not very good at language. So that is not a problem, handicap at all. Those things can be easily solved. So in my lecture itself, I have told about the republication, where it is allowed, where do not. Even after completion of your PhD degree and thesis, you are allowed to publish your thesis. Truly appreciate. Okay. Republication. In what cases republication? I have given in my notes. You can go through the slides. Any paper reference previous papers in the course of writing, our own paper is unavoidable. So does the fall under plagiarism? No, that is... Actually, I'm not understanding what you're asking, but what I understood that if already a paper is given as a reference paper, while you are writing your thesis or your own paper is unavoidable. Your own paper? If your own paper is there, nothing wrong in giving it in it. But the content should not be there. It should be in reference. I have clearly told. If you give as a reference, it is not plagiarism. If you just repeat the content in your own thesis, it is plagiarism. Very simple. The content on the table of the previous paper of your own should not be repeated in the same page, same thesis. If it is given as a reference, it is appreciable because it is part two or part three or part four. Attendance link venum kekkraangala avangalukku attendance varliya network problem da. In cases republication allowed, that is in my presentation itself, I have given 6 points in republication. அதே திரும்ப கேட்டுட்டு இருக்கீங்க. இட் இஸ் தேர் ஆல்ரெடி, யூ ப்ளீஸ் கோ இன் டு இட். யூ ஹாவ் இட் சார், என்ன சொல்றாங்க? யூ ஹாவ் இட் சார், தட் இஸ் மை க்வெஸ்சன். செல்ஃப் பிளஜாரிசம் அக்செப்டட் இன் ஜர்னல்ஸ் அது என்ன அக்செப்டடா இல்லையான்னு கேக்குறாங்களா இஸ் தேர் அக்செப்டட் அன்பு கருசி செல்ஃப் பிளஜாரிசம் அக்செப்டட் இன் ஜர்னல்ஸ் No, self-plagiarism, I'm once again telling you, you can give, if you have a paper reference or a conference paper being published or a conference proceeding is there, that you can give as a reference. Not the same word and sentences or the content. You can take the idea. How you improve the idea is not a plagiarism. But what you have published in the first paper should not be redundant in the second paper. And also in your thesis, it should not be at any page. ஏ ஜெயிச்சா கொஞ்ச நேரத்துக்கானோன்னு அப்படியே ஒரு ஒரு கிளவுடி ஆகுது தெரியும் இந்த ஸ்கிரீன் பார்த்துக்கிட்டே இருக்கும்ல ஒரு மாதிரி கிளவுடி ஆகுது பிளஜரிசம் There are different, I don't know which is, that depends on the quality. Actually, some journals are following, will turn it. Turn it in. One software that is fine. In other universities, they are following turn it in. Why we are following Utkut? So what they are actually analyzing, I don't know exactly, but they are following the sentences, same sentences, etc. Some cases also presented to me. But plagiarism, what is available here in scientific, you can follow it. I'm not the correct person to assess which is right or which is wrong. Thanks. I have to thank our Dean Faculty of Science for having given him a chance. It actually, as a good teacher or a teacher, if you are meeting the people visible or invisible, giving certain ideas what you are knowing is really giving happiness. It is really called as a happiness. As if I am taking a Mudhalayar Kadai Alva at Chidambaram. It's a very fine one. Thanks for the cooperation. When anything is missing, that is my mistake. And anything appreciable is only due to God. Thank you for having given me a chance. Meet you again. And I will go through all your assignments and mark it and give it to a dean. Any doubt, you please clarify with dean. Anything is there, you give the mail to me. That's all. Thank you.
I'm really proud and really heartfully I want to thank our professor, Dr. S. Kabilan, for having accepted our invitation at the first very go. He did not even hesitate and he accepted our invitation with pleasure. And he has spent this afternoon time with you from 3 to 5. So we have, each one of us have learned a lot from these 8 hours of lecture. So I'm sure that you budding students, PhD scholars, who are aiming for the highest degree will be benefited by these lectures. So we thank you, sir, on behalf of the Faculty of Science, complete Faculty of Science, because this is for full faculty. So thank you very much for giving your valuable time and spending it with our students. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much. So dear students, this is just a small announcement. We will meet tomorrow onwards from 4 o'clock onwards. And Monday, all full-time scholars will have to go to the Central Library at 11 o'clock. From 15th onwards, you have to go to the library for offline classes in the morning session. Thank you, one and all. Thank you all. We'll meet tomorrow at 4 o'clock. Thank you so much, sir. Sir, and the assignments, I'm just concerning, I don't value for you.